Hi everyone, how are you today? Welcome back to RC10 for kindergarten, where you learn, I learn, we all learn about the RC10, and this is Huang. Before I start, I strongly recommend that you watch the lesson 1 first, and then download the RC10 CM PDF files posted on my website so that you can follow along with this video. Also, I am very excited to let you know that my e-learning course is finally up and running. All the reading materials, the homeworks, and the quiz will be posted online as we go along. If you want to have access to this e-learning course, then you need to go to my website, rc10forkindergarten.com, and sign up for our mailing list. As soon as I have your first and last name, and your email address, then I should be able to add you to the course. After signing up, please make sure that you check your email for a confirmation link. There is one last thing I would like to mention here is that, although I have spent many hours to record these videos and prepare the course materials, I am also paying for the domain and the web hosting service myself. However, I do not charge a fee for accessing the course. The course is free. So, all I'm asking you for is, after May 31st, 2013, if you are finding value in the course, then could you please kindly make a donation to a local charity of your choice? I prefer the Children's Orphan Home, Children's Hospital, or any organization that are helping children. Whatever you feel right for you and can afford. It could be $20, $50, $100 or more, and then send me the receipt of your donation. Then I would give you a full access to the course. I just received the first receipt last week, and I would like to take this opportunity to say thank you to Mrs. Billy for her donation to Palmetto Health Children's Hospital in South Carolina. Thank you so much for your kindness and generosity. All right, without further ado, let's get started. Inside this video, first, I'm going to talk about the basic step to assign an RC10 CM code. Then, we are going to do some code exercise together. And lastly, I will give you the homework at the end, so let's get right into it. Here are the basic coding steps. First, you need to identify the main term in the diagnosis statement. You already know how to do this from the first lesson. Next, you locate the main term in the alphabetic index, which is the volume 2 of your book. For those of us who do not have the book and currently use the PDF file, you just open the file instead. Remember, the main terms are listed alphabetically and printed in bold type and begin with a capital letter. You must review any subterm or more specific subterm if applicable. From this step, you should be able to obtain a code or codes. However, it's very, very important that you must follow the next step, which is to verify the code number in the tabular list. You might wonder why. Well, it's just because the tabular list would give you more specific codes. Having said that, you should never rely on your memory or use only the alphabetic index to assign the code, or you may run the risk of using the wrong RC10 CM diagnosis code. So please keep that in mind. In this step, you also need to make sure your code is completed. Whether it is a 3, a 4, a 5, a 6, or a 7 character code. For example, if the code indicates that a 7 character is required, then it must be included. In addition, you need to read all information given in order to obtain the best code that describes the patient's specific disease or condition. After that, The last step is to enter the code to medical record, and you're done. Alright, to reinforce what we just learned, let's do this coding exercise together. But before we start, for this coding exercise, I would like you to pause the video and open two PDF files that you have downloaded from my website. The first one is the IC10CM Index to Disease and Injury. And the second one is the Tabular List of Disease and Injury. Okay, please code the following diagnosis: fever. This is the IC10CM Index to Disease and Injury. How to spell fever? F-E-V-E-R. So please click on the F here. Then I want you to scroll out of page until you see the main term fever. It will work better if you use the up and down arrow key instead of the scroll wheel. We're almost there. Alright, here it is. Fever. When you find the correct main term, please jot down the correct code that follows. In this case, R50.9. Now, the next step is to verify this code in the tabular list. So let's minimize the index and open the tabular list. This is the IC10CM tabular list of disease and injury. We have to find out where is R50.9. If you scroll down here, it belongs to chapter 18, Sun Symptom, R00 to R99. Please click on it. Okay, and then you go down here, you're going to see R50.9 is in this range, general symptom and sign. Please click on it. Alright, so here it is, R50.9, fever unspecified. It's not that bad, right? Okay, let's try the next one. Call the following diagnosis: seizure. How to spell seizure? S-E-I-G-U-R-E. So please click on the S here. Use the down arrow key and scroll down the page. Almost there. S-E-I. Here it is. Seizure. So please jot down the code. R56.9. Then you minimize this file. Open the tabular list. Let's find out where is R56.9. Again, it belongs to chapter 18, Sign Symptom, R00 to R99. Please click on it and scroll down. Again, it should be in this range, R50 to R69. So please click on it. R56.9, so go down a little bit more. Okay, here it is. R56.9, unspecified convulsion or seizure convulsion, NOS. In other words, unspecified. How you doing so far? Okay, let's try another one. Call the following diagnosis: tension headache. First, you need to identify the main term in this diagnosis statement. What is the main term? Headache, that describes the condition. And tension is a term that describes the type of the headache. Alright, let's open the index file. Alright, first, How to spell headache? H-E-A-D-A-C-H-E. So I want you to click on the edge here and scroll down the page until you see the main term headache. Almost there. Okay, here it is. Then you need to find out what is the subterm. In this case, tension. So scroll down until you see tension. Almost there. Here it is. And this is the code G44.209. I want you to jot down this code and then minimize this file. The next step is we need to verify this code in the tabular. So open the tabular list. Okay. G44. Where is G44? It belongs to chapter 6, Disease of Nervous System, G00 to G99. Please click on it. And where is G44? It should be in this range, G40 to G47. So please click on it. Then scroll down the page until you see G44. All right, here it is. G44.209. Tension type headache, unspecified, not intractable. Tension headache, not otherwise specified, or in other words, unspecified. So how are you doing so far? I hope you got it right. Alright, this is your homework. Using the alphabetic index and tabular list, call the following diagnosis: chronic hypertrophy of tonsil, bunion, left crack toe, acute bleeding, peptic ulcer, benign cyst of right breast, recurrent direct right inguinal hernia with gangrene. If you take your time and strictly follow the basic coding step, then you should be fine. I will post the answer keys on my website. Also, if you need more homework, please sign up for our mailing list. Next video, we are going to learn about the IC10CM convention. That's all for now. Thank you so much for watching. And please don't forget to leave me a comment or feedback. I really appreciate it. Until next time, have a great day.